Humans are one of the dominant forces shaping the natural world today, like rain or wind. But unlike rain or wind, humans shape the world in ways that are bad for bird populations. So let's take a deep breath and measure the ways that humans are impacting birds. Hunting and capture. If you're watching this video, you probably live in a part of the world where hunting is regulated. The goal of regulating hunting is to only hunt sustainable species in sustainable ways. But in other parts of the world, like developing nations in the tropics, hunting has led to a more than 50% decline in bird populations compared to areas where hunting does not occur. The biggest effects were found close to urban markets, showing that small-scale hunters trying to make a living are one of the biggest causes. I would rank this threat moderate because it depends what kind of laws and law enforcement are in place, as well as local culture and rates of poverty. Airplanes. Air travel is increasing globally. There were 40 million airline flights in 2019. Using some older data, there were 22,000 bird and aircraft strikes reported between 1990 and 1998 in the United States. That probably is an underestimate. Pilots might not notice every single bird strike, and they might not report every single bird strike. But with millions of flights, while 22,000 birds is a lot of birds, it's a tiny fraction of some of the other problems we'll talk about.
I would rank this threat minor.
Noise and disturbance. Studies have found that bird populations decline near roads. The biggest reason is noise. And this effect carries further than you might expect. A busy road like a freeway reduces breeding bird populations for up to 1 mile away. The closer to the road, the bigger the population drop. As road building continues, this effect will increase. But it doesn't actually kill birds, just deprives them of places to live. Roads can be a cause of habitat fragmentation. Let's look at a hypothetical forest. It's a big habitat, and a freeway is built right down the middle. Not very much land is missing, but it's very hard for a lot of animals to access the whole habitat. We now have two separate, smaller habitats as far as those animals are concerned. And like we talked about with traffic noise, there's a zone of disturbance around the freeway. So a small land use change affects the habitat way more than you would expect based on land area alone.
I would rank this threat low, but steadily increasing.
Towers, turbines, power lines, and communication towers. Power lines kill between 130 million and 174 million birds annually in the United States alone, plus between 4 and 50 million birds that collide with communication towers, plus 100,000 to 300,000 birds killed by wind turbines. Add it all up, and we're talking 134 million to 224 million birds every single year in the United States. Towers with lights are the worst because the lights attract, then trap birds that are flying by. Birds fly into the lit area, then circle around, apparently unwilling to fly back out into the dark until they crash into something or land in exhaustion. This problem is worse in developed countries because there are more cell towers and power lines, but this will keep increasing. We're building more towers all the time, and developing countries are also building more towers.
I would rank this threat as moderate.
Glass and lights.
Glass strikes are one of the biggest killers of birds in the world. This is a big range, but somewhere between 100 million and a billion birds are killed annually in the United States, billion with a B.
Why? Because glass is designed to be invisible. Also because glass reflects sky and trees and looks like a safe flying path through a city. Lit office windows at night look the same, like a safe path. And if there are lights on the outside of the building, birds experience that trapping effect.
Glass is one of the biggest killers of birds worldwide, and I would rank this threat on the high end of moderate.
Invasive species and pets. Wherever humans go, they bring animals. Some of the animals they bring are very bad for local animals. Invasive predators like cats, rodents, dogs, and pigs have contributed to more than half of all bird, mammal, and reptile extinctions in the last 500 years. And invasive species are one of the pressures on an additional 600 species that are vulnerable to extinction in the near future. The two worst human-associated animals are rodents, which eat eggs and chicks, and cats, which eat adult birds. It's estimated that cats, just cats, kill 1.3 to 4 billion birds annually in the United States alone. That doesn't count any other invasive species or part of the world. Cats are a serious bird crisis.
I would rank this threat severe.
Habitat loss. This is by far the hardest source to measure. We have numbers on how much land is being converted. Millions of acres are turning into cities and farms and roads. All the resources in those areas become unavailable to the animals that lived there. So they have a choice of moving or starving, which isn't much of a choice. But with human encroachment from every angle, there are only so many places to go. The end result is that some species will go extinct.
This threat is of such great magnitude that it's hard to describe, but it's definitely worse than cats. A healthy bird population with plenty of space and resources can recover from cat predators, as they do from other types of predators. But what if the resources that the species needs to recover are taken away? The species gets damaged, and it just doesn't recover. I would rank this threat as severe and steadily increasing.
For the total impact of all these factors, a study was done which estimated total bird populations in North America and found that there are 3 billion fewer birds than there were in 1970. That's one quarter of birds gone in the last 50 years.
This was a huge list of threats, but the point is that there's so much we can do if we care enough to try. Humans have kind of accidentally changed the natural world, and we've had all these unintended consequences to doing things. But now we have an advantage if we care enough to act on it, which is that we know what those unintended consequences are. So, we can find the worst ones and the cheapest to fix and just fix them.
Here are some really obvious solutions. Don't put upwards-facing lights on buildings and billboards. Don't light a structure unless you have to. Build towers far away from where birds gather, like wetlands. Build fewer towers and consolidate the ones we have. Keep all cats indoors. Make glass visible to birds using ultraviolet paint, window stickers, or non-reflective films. And protect gigantic swaths of land as parks and reserves.
Individually and as a culture, we need to protect the planet from ourselves. Humans are one of the biggest destructive forces on the planet, but we're also smart enough to protect it if we choose to. All we have to do is resolve to do better from this point onwards. So, which of these solutions will you do? Thanks for learning about our impact on the planet. You can watch one of these other videos to learn about the amazing world that we live in, and you could subscribe to know when future videos come out. Thanks for stopping by this week to learn what makes life awesome.